On an otherwise sunny and windy day in late April 2025, the Iberian Peninsula became the stage of an energy drama that reads like a dystopian sci-fi plot, except it really happened. At exactly 12:35 p.m., parts of the Spanish and Portuguese electrical grids experienced a rare and dangerous phenomenon, a zero where frequency plummeted to 0 hertz, forcing the shutdown of nuclear plants and bringing Europe to the brink of a cascading blackout. It wasn't sabotage, it wasn't cyber warfare, it was too much sunshine, too much wind, and an unsurprising market maneuver that broke the system. As Europe scrambles to decarbonize, Spain and Portugal have surged ahead in renewable energy generation. Their hydroelectric reservoirs are brimming, their wind farms spinning, and their solar parks absorbing every sun drop. On this particular day, a trifecta of blazing sun, strong winds, and overflowing dams meant that Iberia was not just energy independent, it was exporting cheap green electricity at record volumes. Meanwhile, nuclear plants were idling at minimal capacity, providing only base load power, the stable, always on supply, that keeps the grid's heartbeat at 50 hertz. At 11:44 a.m., French demand surged. As is standard in the pan-European grid, French regulators began pulling in cheap Iberian electricity to satisfy their consumers and resell it to the neighboring Germany. Spain responded by reconnecting solar plants that had previously been curtailed due to overproduction. Prices dropped further. Germany started re-exporting to Eastern Europe. It was a beautiful example of European energy cooperation. Until it wasn't. At 12:33 p.m., the French grid regulator, likely spooked by frequency instability or market pressures, suddenly disconnected multiple production nodes without warning. This abrupt move forced 70 million French consumers to lean even more heavily on Iberian supply. The effect was catastrophic. The Spanish grid, which had been ramping up production for export, suddenly became an island system with nowhere to send its excess power. The inverters, turbines, and solar arrays didn't slow down, they surged. In grid dynamics, excess generation without demand causes the frequency to spike. Automated protection systems kick in if it goes too far from 50 Hz, and when they do, they shut down everything down. This is what industry experts call zero. A state in which grid frequency collapses to 0 hertz, nuclear and thermal plants are forcibly shut down, and renewables lose their synchronizing reference point. Emergency diesel generators and synchronous condensers are sometimes used to restore the 50 hertz rhythm, but rebooting a grid isn't as simple as flipping a switch. It requires careful restoration through grid cells, opening sections of the grid, matching supply and demand, and rebalancing frequency, all without frying sensitive infrastructure or destabilizing neighboring countries. The implications of this event go far beyond engineering. There are whispers that the French regulator's sudden disconnection might have been financially motivated. France might have profited handsomely by importing dirt cheap energy from Iberia and rerouting to wealthier markets until the system cracked. Spain, meanwhile, bore the brunt of the disruption. Solar and wind investors are raising concerns, grid operators are reviewing protocols, and regulators across Europe are asking tough questions about interconnection logic, market manipulation, and whether the rush to renewables has outpaced the safety net. Lessons from the brink. Renewables need synchronous friends. Solar and wind can't stabilize the grid alone. They require nuclear, hydro, or thermal plants to set the clock. Grid interconnections must be smarter. Disconnection without coordination can have continent-wide effects. Too much of a good thing is still a problem. Overproduction without demand, balancing turns abundance into chaos. Europe needs an energy reality check. While the green revolution is essential, so is the infrastructure to handle it. Spain and Portugal's brass with blackouts may become a case study in grid management textbooks. It proves that the energy transition is not just about generating clean power, it's about orchestrating it. Like a symphony, the grid requires harmony, timing, and a skilled conductor. Because when the rhythm fails, even the cleanest energy turns dangerous. The European Union is now launching an inquiry into the April 2025 incident. Meanwhile, Spanish and Portuguese regulators are accelerating plans to implement real-time AI-based grid balancing, better interconnection safeguards, and islanding strategies to prevent total collapse in future surges. The good news, no infrastructure was destroyed. The bad news, it came terrifyingly close. That was all, guys. Bye-bye.